Welcome to Qt Widgets and More. If you're using clang-tidy, you likely have a .clang-tidy file. Did you know that you are not allowed to have comments in there? Well, it's actually pretty useful to have. So watch this episode to learn how you can get that. All I want, what I really, really want, I wanna have more static type checks. Sorry, now you cannot get that song off your head. I'm just evil, I admit. I had a .clang-tidy file that I wanted to polish. I wanted to go through all the possible clang-tidy checks and see if they make sense for me. So I wanted to add groups of them, and whenever I found something that was just too noisy, I wanted to have a comment in my .clang file, clang-tidy file, saying, no, this check here doesn't make any sense because, well, maybe one of them was complaining about including the CPP file from the previous episode. What I learned, however, was that it's complicated. Just as relationship status on Facebook. It's complicated because you are allowed to have comments in your .clang-tidy file, but not within the string of the checks. What it actually does, even though you can take your check string and split it over multiple lines, what it does in the end is to take and remove all those backslash ends, so it's one long line again. And if you have one of those lines that says hash mark and something, well, it'll just comment out the rest of the file, basically. Not very convenient. So I wrote a small script, and that's what I'm going to share with you in this episode. What you see here is my .clang-tidy file, if you haven't seen that before. So you can see it's just a key value pair here, so checks, and then a list or a string of all the checks. And they are comma separated, and well, there isn't really much more to say about it. You can have asterisks to tell about groups, so I want all the checks, but I don't want those checks from Android, for example. I don't want that the minus sign here saying I don't want them. I don't want those from Darwin. I don't want this or that and so on. The other part of this is a bunch of options. And when you go and look up, so CPP core guidelines, special member functions, if you look that up, it tells you, well, you can set this variable here to value 1 if you want this or that facility to not be checked or not to be complained about. So what I did was I simply created, as you can see up here, this file. I shouldn't be editing that anymore because it's generated. What I want instead is to edit this file here. So that looks like this, and you can see that's just the check options down here, so not much to see there. Or this file here, if I can cut and paste properly, I obviously cannot. .clang-tidy. Oh, come on, .checks. There we are. And what this is what this whole episode is about. It namely allows me to write comments in here, as you can see, but also observe the lack of a comma after each of these. And that is actually the other part of it, because clang-tidy will not, unfortunately, complain if there is a check that it doesn't know about. It'll just say, okay, so you don't want the open mp dash star minus circon dash star. It's like, what? No. Oh, I forgot the comma in between those two. So that's the other purpose of this. Now I don't write the commas at all anymore. I can have comments saying, I should try this eventually, or I want all the checks by default, or over here I can write comments and that all works fine. And I should not write all the pesky commas in between that I always forget. And with that, all I need to do is that I need to run this script that is called updatClangTidy.py, and it will simply generate me a new file. And you can see with minus h, it tells you I can actually list all the checks, which is a nice little, it's not that much work compared to doing that with the clang-tidy itself, but hey, I can do that, and I can see there's 225 checks enabled right now. There is one problem with all of this, namely that the more tests you enable, the longer it takes. Surprise. Well, it takes a little longer also when you run it from within Qt Creator. And if you have any good idea how to optimize this, I am very much all ears, because at this stage, we're talking about that modifying a complex file of mine and waiting for Qt Creator to start complaining takes almost 21 seconds. So it can only run three of those at full steam every minute, which is a slightly annoying. I also tried to just enable all of them, and that resulted in, I'm just looking at my screen here, 39 seconds for 468 checks altogether. So I set out for the task. There must be some of those that is taking longer than others. So I wrote, as you can see on the script that you can download there if you want to play more with it, it actually has support for running each text check after the other and timing how long it takes. And I tried doing that, and then I summed up how long did it take to run each of the tests one at a time. Well, actually, I did subtract the shortest test from all of them, because there's got to be some time in parsing and setting up the infrastructure that can be reused throughout everything. So I took those, I think, 6 or 7 seconds and subtracted from each of the tests. And then what was left is what I attributed to being to run that test. And then I summed all of that up and it got me 120 seconds. And if you compare that to the 39 seconds, that's three times as long as it took to run all of them in one go. So there's obviously some extra optimization for the groups in there, I would assume that works. But in any case, what I tried to do was to sort them by this one is taking the longest and this one is the shortest, but it was the longest that I was interested in. Unfortunately, the longest didn't take more than 3 seconds or so. And they were within 1 to 2 seconds, most of them. So there wasn't much gained from doing that. So if you have any ideas, then this is my support group. Please help me out. I want my Qt Creator to run this faster, but I also want as many checks as possible. Now, once you got re-energized about checking your code for all the static checks that you can possibly do, what you likely will want to do is to run clang-tidy on your whole code base with just one check. And that is possible. I even provided you with a script to do so in the last episode on clang-tidy, which is half a year ago or something like that. However, when I recorded this episode here, I started preparing at least for it. I started going like, why do I only run it on a single core? Why not run it in parallel like when I do Ninja that runs in lots of cores at the same time? And I realized that my script was the culprit of this, of course, and that there actually was a script that was released together with clang-tidy that's called run clang-tidy. You can look at it. It's a relatively simple Python script if you want details in there, but or you can run clang-tidy -h to get some help for it. But what you basically need to do is call the run clang-tidy, specify -p, and then the directory in which your binary or your build is in. And in there, you need to generate the compilation database. Remember, inside of Qt Creator, if you don't remember, go and look at that episode. Inside Qt Creator, go to build, generate compilation database. And then minus checks equal to, and here's a small trick, start it out with minus asterisks, because otherwise there is 20-ish, I think, checks that will be in there by default. And then comma, and then whatever check you want. Finally, minus fix if you even want clang-tidy, if it can, to fix your code. There's actually a bit more to say about my script. I almost forgot, but well, glad I didn't. One problem that it actually solves is that if you tried to have your clang-tidy over multiple lines, then you could not import that from within Qt Creator anymore. Let me just show you what I'm talking about here. So inside projects, down to clang tools, you specify the setup you have there, clang-tidy, and here you can either select which one you want, or you can say just use the clang-tidy. And if you want a At some point, you can also go here and say, I really want to specify, and then you can just cut and paste that file in here if you want to see exactly which one has been selected and which hasn't. But that did not work if you had them split out over multiple lines. And then there is one more thing. Namely, you want to run that script whenever any of these two files changes. For that, the script actually can help you. If you run it with minus minus print CMake snippet, it will spit out some code here for you that you can cut and paste into your CMake file that says that whenever this file is dirty, this clang tidy settings or the clang tidy checks, whenever they are dirty, then we should be recompiling this one. Now you ask yourself, is that really safe? Will I not forget to do that to run CMake? Well, whenever you run your clang-tidy checks, we should always have compiled your scripts already. So, or your scripts, you should have compiled your source code already. It's not strictly required, but it's a very good idea that you are sure that there are no compile errors in there. Thank you for watching yet another episode of Qt Widgets and More. And if you have any solution to my clang-tidy taking enormous amount of time from within Qt Creator, by all means, do let me know. And until next time, have a great time.